got this guy who comes in, and it's one finger, flexor tendon, zone 2, small finger. What do you do first? Very first thing at the evaluation. Hitting the ground running here.
Don't you usually test to see if the tendon's actually intact before you start?
Nope.
Oh no?
No. Very first thing is you've got to develop rapport. So I develop rapport first. And I make sure that they know that they're safe with me. So this is exactly the thing that I do with my staff, right? Like, this is what I do because we want more patients come in. And I don't know about you guys, but even before, depending on, obviously it depends on where you work, right? Obviously, if you work in a private practice versus like a corporate type of thing versus doctors, but at the end of the day, we're always thinking about like, how do we, you know, get our patients, and then how do we keep our patients? And so one of the first things that I do is that I like to get rapport first. I like to tell them like, hey, and when I say this, and I'm drilling this into my own staff. They need to know your name, because no matter where you are, because you might not stay at your place, right? You might stay at your place, you might move on to another place. You want people to remember your name. I have a hard name. So, you know, I don't care how they remember me, but I usually have them remember my name some form or fashion. But I really develop a rapport with them. And, you know, it's important because especially with flexor tendons, compliance is a huge thing, right? Compliance is really huge. I think I had a question on compliance. There's always a compliance issue. I don't care what kind of patients you're working with. There's always some form or fashion of a compliance issue. And we always think it's about us, and it's not. I'm sorry, but it's, you know, it's some of it is about us, right? Some of it's about us, but so much of it is about them. And I always like to put it on my patients.